money is on Tower Tornadoes, but who doesn't want to see Nick versus Molt in the final? They've never played each other before, I don't think.
Do they even know each other? I'm not sure.
Yeah, I don't know. So here we go. Molt's in the finals. Who is going to join them? Nemsensei, Nickatnyte, and Red along the top. C. McHugh clashed with Cam and Blue along the bottom. We have a Giant coming down the left side and Mega Minion getting pulled by the Knight on the other side. Now, Golem versus Giant. I normally would favor Golem in that matchup. What do you think?
I'm not quite sure. Rummy, what's happening? Break this down with me real quick.
All right, what's happening here is that they're trying to get this Golem set up. The defenders are coming out for Nemsensei and Nickatnyte. Great reactive fireball, took out the Flying Machine and weakened the Baby Dragon, but without any more support troops kind of ran out there behind. The Golem doesn't have the ability to really get to the tower and be effective. The Electro Wizard continually resets that Inferno Tower, keeping it from heating it up too much.
This taps him down. Wow. It's great to be able to supplement your big heavy tank with something that can reset the Inferno Tower, but this is a big push coming in the left lane. The Golem can work really well in double elixir time when you can get a bigger push set up, but until then, the Giant's really getting value in here. Tornado pulls him closer, but not to the King!
That's not where you want to put it, and the Knight walking close to the tower is a bit of a risk there because the Baby Dragon can splash onto both defending troops and the tower.
Rummy, I want to see if we can hear what these guys are saying. Let's be quiet.
Let's listen in.
I have a miner, and I have a... it's so quiet. Oh, I want to go miner. Yeah.
No, they're being exceptionally quiet, as it turns out. So here we are, back in the caster's booth. This tower is down to 650 or less, 583. Now, the Golem has had a really hard time getting to the tower. The only damage they've managed to get on the tower is from spells, none from the actual...
Ooh, whoa!
Nice lightning takes out the Mega Minion and that Flying Machine. Lots of big action going over on the left.
Double Electro Wizard is not where you want to be, though. Double Electro Wizard can stun and hold back so much. The Tornado pulls it back with no splash damage.
Whoa! Little bit of health left on that E-Wiz on the backside, but Ice Spirit takes him out. Little snowball fight on the red side of the arena. Can this Golem push break through, though? They really need to tear this thing down.
I mean, the absolute MVP of this matchup so far seems to be Baby Dragon. It's so hard to deal with on both sides. It doesn't really die to any spells. It survives lightning, and it's just been great on for both sides to keep the things off their tower. However, we are 30 seconds left. This tower is going to go down to poison. Only 24 seconds left for C.McQ and Clash with Cam to try and tie it up. They have about 755 health to go.
The unfortunate thing for them is that they'd really prefer to have a big old Golem attack going on in there. Knight not able to reach the tower quickly enough might leave them high and dry unless they can get another big spell off the left side. Can they do it in 10 seconds?
Trying to cycle log is going to do not enough. A second log comes down and that's going to do it. 96 damage to a 95 health tower means we are going to overtime.
By the skin of their teeth, but hey, a win is a win, and they're actually ahead in damage now, looking pretty good up against the Ultra Knights.
Flying Machine is going to support this Mega Minion and Knights, or the
Dang.
Miner's coming. Wow, double poison, double miner. We've seen this already. Now remember, poison stacks now. Poison used to not do that. Only one poison could affect at a time, but now two poisons will both do their damage simultaneously, meaning double miner, double poison is twice as nice.
A noxious combo, twice hitting that right side tower, and the Knights have pulled ahead in damage overall. 1731 on the right side tower, and they're getting under fire from a Giant, but he's locked onto the Inferno. It doesn't look like he's going to make it to the right side tower.
This is one of C.McHugh's favorite cards, is the Inferno Tower. It's so good at stopping tanks and getting these great positive elixir trades. I actually think they're setting up for a big push here. You might see the Miner's going to come down the tank, and I think this might be one of their opportunities to turn this around.
Here we go. Even if he takes a few hits in the right side over here from these incoming troops, he still will be able to build up for the big attack. It's just all about whether or not C.McHugh and Clash with Cam can finish off the Giant that's coming on in. And with a 5-for-5 trade on defense, looks like the Inferno Tower is going to get the job done.
Great job with the poison and the tornado. They're trying to keep that Mega Minion from working. The most important thing to do against a Golem deck is isolate the Golem. If you can get rid of the support troops, the Golem is easy peasy. You can tornado that to your King Tower. You can pull it around with the building. The biggest challenge is taking out the Electro Wizards, Night Witches, and Baby Dragons that are backing it up.
Nice bit of splash damage. Trying to get that Baby Dragon to lock onto the tower and get a few hits in, but triple digits already from the Golemite explosion. And it's looking like that, the Flying Machine manages to survive. Baby Dragon can't get the lock on tower, though, with the E-Wiz zapping and resetting her.
9:30 left. Now, the Electro Wizard backing up the Giant is designed to keep that Inferno Tower from heating up. The minions come down to distract, but they're taken out quickly. Is the Electro Wizard hitting the Inferno Tower? I don't think so.
No, but it didn't really get a good chance to lock on. Did manage to burn it up eventually, but the minions provided a big threat, and it's going to be difficult leveraging that Inferno Tower to set up defense against the Ultra Knights.
This is so close. Just a minute left until we go to a draw. Both towers are in triple digits. It's going to come down to one spell, one minor, a split-second photo finish. There's no other way this game can end.
Well, it's a big attack coming in over the right side. This might just do it, but looks like defense is going to hold up just long enough. Minor connects, and are they going to make it in there? I'm not quite sure. Mega Minion held off at the very last
Lightning
second.
Will do it. They have Lightning. Remember, they have Lightning in the deck, and
Boom.
They do it. Lightning pulls it off. See McHugh and Clash with Cam take the game.
Nicely done to those guys. The Tower Tornado's holding on strong. We've got a little bit to hear from our friends up on the stage, though. Why don't we take Rumham's just a try hard? I like to see the people's heroes going in for a win once in a while, you know? Let's see if they can pull it off here. We're back in game now. Nemsensei and Nickatnyte duking it out against CMQ and Clash with Cam.
The slightly faster Baby Dragon is going to fly ahead of the Mega Minion to try to tank, but the Miner gets there first and holds the line. Now the Baby Dragon is splashing. Oh, did they get at least one attack onto the tower? Pretty good.
Nice defense out here on the right side. Looks like it's not going to be any troops connecting, but Poison is able to tick it down about 500 hit points overall.
And the second Miner comes in, once again intercepted by the Lumberjack. Now, this Lumberjack makes a great point man for a push because when he dies, he drops a Rage spell that can help back up whatever else you have. Whoa, two flyers come across the bridge, and they're trying to take that thing out before he does too much damage.
He zooms in fast, and he makes his friends work even faster as well. Rage spell gives him a 35% boost. Or is it 30 now? I can't remember if they changed
35%. The Flying Machine locks on, but gets held off. Ice Spirit MVP, two pushes in a row. The Ice Spirit, the first time, reset the Inferno Dragon, keeping the Inferno Tower a little bit healthy, and then used it again there to stop another push from connecting to the tower.
They both tried to predict that Miner over on the right side in the top corner with those Knights, but just couldn't quite catch it.
Ha-ha, ha-ha.
Uh-huh.
There we go. So we have two Knights. Oh, what a rocket! Great prediction there that there was going to be some troops. Unfortunately, the P.E.K.K.A. A survives a rocket, and B is going to kill both those Knights and still counterattacks. I don't know how good that rocket really was.
Yeah, I think Nemsensei, Nickatnyte are feeling pretty healthy here. Even though they just soaked a big hit, they're going in for an even bigger counterattack. Need something to deal with this Princess, though. I haven't really been seeing anything that they can usually use reliably to take her out. Finally, the log rolls in, but she got quite a few shots off on that attack.
Yeah, the nice thing about Princess is she's so good on defense. Long range allows her to shoot either lane pretty effectively, that if she gets like three or four shots off, I don't care if you log her after that. I already got my value, buddy. This time, Lumberjack goes down.
But the rage will benefit the Princess Tower there. Shooting away at that attack.
Oh. Knight came out too early. Does not actually, it's tanking, but it's nothing shooting the Flying Machine. Is it really tanking?
Wah, 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 wah.
Dark Goblin on the counterattack. The Mega Minion's going to chop it in half, but the Miner gets close, gets a few swings. Electro Wizard and Mega Minion on the counterattack. I'm not sure what they're going to use to stop it, because you don't want to drop your Inferno Tower and have the Electro Wizard take care of it.
Another rocket straight for the tower. These guys are unafraid of anything. Defending against the attacks coming on in. Mega Minion swipes away at the Knight, but it looks like just another rocket log combo will finish it off. Nice catch there with the Lumberjack, keeping that Miner off the tower.
I believe that they got the read on their opponent that we have Rocket and they don't, so we can get into these Rocket trades and our opponent's not going to be able to do anything about it, other than maybe just knock the tower down in the regular old-fashioned way. So that one's going to go down, and we have a 1-1 tie right now that's going into overtime in just 8 seconds.
Razor-thin margin of lead, I guess, for the Nemsensei Nickatnyte team. They tore that tower down a little bit quicker and forced the Elixir out from the guys on bottom, throwing a spell at the right side tower. Looks like the damage total is just about the same over on the left side, too. We hadn't seen too much action over there just yet.
Crazy Ice Spirit there held both those Mega Minions in place. They both died to the Executioner and kept him alive, forcing an Electro Wizard reaction play. Double Miner and a Poison's coming down. The Goblin Gang is going to get shredded by the second Poison as well. Little bit of damage there, but that's a lot of Elixir committed to only do about 500 damage.
I think those Ice Spirits are just crazy by definition. I mean, they just throw themselves at whatever attacker and die in the process.
Suicidal. Oh, no!
Whoa.
That is a roll! Well, okay. If it hit the Mega Minion as well, that would have been the most valuable rocket we saw today. Instead, four Elixir worth of troops go down and 500 damage dealt to the tower.
Super aggressive Flying Machine up there. It can't quite lock onto the tower, though, and that looks like it's going to be a good defense for CMQ and Clash with Cam on the bottom. They can't finish off the left side with a rocket, and it looks like the Poison will be able to take out the remainder of their support troops there. But what can Nemsensei and Nickatnyte build up here.
Rocket wins the game! C. McHugh and Clash with Cam have tied the match. Oh, no, I'm sorry, they've won the match 2-0. And they have, that's 2-0, 4-0 on the day. C. McHugh, Clash with Cam going to the finals. We'll be right back.